welcome to Pebbles. Myself, Manmeet, presenting Mom's Diary to you. So the topic which I'm going to take today from our Mom's Diary is an interesting topic plus a useful topic for both our stay-at-home moms and working moms. So the topic which I'm going to take today is regarding the meal planning. Yes, meal planning, the important part of weekend, or you can say important part of a weekday. This video will be especially helpful for our working moms. Lastly, I made a video on time and management. There I talked about meal planning. So in comment section, many people asked me regarding this meal planning section. So I thought, why not I give you a meal planning detail. Basically, what is meal planning? Meal planning is throughout the week, whatever we have to cook so that we can have a whole week, we can have a homemade cooked food, a healthy food, and we can provide our family also with both. Because in morning, we all are in a hush bush, whether we are a working or non-working mom or a stay-at-home mom, because stay-at-home moms are also very busy in giving tiffin, sending kids to school. Everything is very hodgepodge in morning, in a busy morning, you can say. So to come out of this busy morning, this meal planning is very helpful. So let's get started. So before starting a meal planning, you have to make a menu for your whole week. Yes, you have to make for a menu for a whole week. This is very important. First point is menu. Make a menu. In this part, breakfast, lunch, dinner. In these three sections, and if in snacks time you are at your place and kids are there, husband is there till that time, so you can add on with snacks also. If you're having this three part of the day, breakfast, lunch and dinner, so you can accordingly plan for the whole week. Suppose on Monday, for example, you decided to make rava upma. In lunch, you decided to make chole puri. And in dinner, you want something light. Maybe your this curry will be left and you just want to make one dry sabzi. For example, you want to make bhindi, okra. If you decide that you will having a gravy with you of chole, so you can prepare a dry sabzi. Suppose okra you are preparing. And if snacks is also there, so you are deciding with a sandwich. So likewise, what are the likes and dislikes of your family, you can prepare this for the whole week. So for example, now if you have decided this, so when you are going to the market, it will be very easy. If you are not having rava or suji at your place, you can get that. The veggies which you require for this, chole if you are not having, okra if you are not having at home. So with this, it will be very easy, and it will be very easy for you to shop also. So before going for a weekend shopping, do plan your meal for a week. Second thing is that clear your fridge. Yes, clear your fridge is very important. Now what do you have to do in clear your fridge? If your fridge will not be clear, so how will you get to know what is remaining, what you have to get? So before going for a shopping, your fridge should be clear. It should be neat and clean so that the other veggies which you will get, you can easily keep them. Okay, so now coming up to the third part, that is preparation. You should make a pre-preparation on weekend, a Sunday evening, a Sunday afternoon. You can do this work. This will take hardly 2 hours, so you have to do that. So I would say prepare
for pre-planning.
This means, suppose if on in pre-planning it will come, if you have decided to make okra on Monday, so you can chop this okra and keep in a airtight container in your refrigerator, so that after coming from work on Monday, if you are a working mom, after coming from work, or if you are a stay-at-home mom also, then also you are not in a hush bash to cut okra first and then make it. So it's better that you can cut this beforehand. Now, the tips which I will continue before are some common tips which you can keep for some common things which you can keep in each and every home. So, fourth is, boil and grate potatoes. Yes, every family eat potatoes in a week according to their taste, according to their lifestyle, how they much like and how much they use the thing. So boil the potatoes, grate few of them after boiling. That grated potatoes you can use for sandwiches, you can use for aloo paratha, anything, whatever you like, you can use for that. So beforehand do this part. This will be very, very helpful to you. So this is some common thing which every home can, at least 90% home will be using this for whole of their week. Now, fifth thing. Make some gravy. Now, what you will do is make some gravy. You will say that if I have to make okra, if I have to make chole, how do you make instant? So what you can do, you can quickly chop the onions. Here you can do the chopping basically. Chop onions and tomatoes in slices, and you can fry them in a little bit of oil, olive oil or whatever you like, and later then you can grate them in the mixer and you can keep in an airtight container in refrigerator. And later on, whenever, if you are in a hurry also, in morning also, if you are in a hurry, so you don't have to eat any outside food, you will just put that gravy inside. You don't have to cut onions or tomatoes. Onions, don't keep raw onions. I'm saying you have to fry it, and then you have to fry the tomatoes within that pan only, and then you have to blend both of the mixtures, and then you can keep, and salt, chili powder, everything else, spices, you can add at that very moment when you are cooking. So this will be very helpful and very easy for you also. If you have made the gravy part, it will be very simple for you. Now, sixth thing is that chop the veggies and store in airtight container. Yes, you can chop the veggies in advance on weekend only. Suppose weekend there are many people at home, your husband must also be there at home, so you can take his help also, and you both can quickly, you can give him something to chop, like you can give them garlic to chop, and later on you can okra, carrots, you can grate and keep for if you want to make carrot and peas. Or you can suppose if you have to make rava upma on Monday, so you can chop everything, beans, potato, except onions, you can chop everything, because and you can store in an airtight container. Here where I have said you can chop onions, here I have said you should fry them out and then keep it after blending. So don't get confused in both the things that I'm saying. And you can if you have to make prepare chole on Monday, so you can overnight soak chole on Sunday only. Then if whatever the veggies you have to make for whole week, you can store in a airtight container, nicely keeping on kitchen towel, so that they are not wet and they don't get spoiled early. So it's better, you can easily do the things. And from my personal experience, I would like to tell you, you should wash the vegetables except few veggies like okra and other few veggies, you should wash them on this spot before you are cooking, because if you will wash this carrot or beans beforehand, so they are little bit wet and definitely they will be spoiled in refrigerator and it will be of no use. So wash when you are about to cook. Now last tip in this meal planning I would like to give is that need a good amount of dough. Yes, on Sunday night, do need a good amount of dough according to your family size, so that till Tuesday and Wednesday that dough should last, and on Wednesday evening again you can knead the dough, which can last for Friday till Saturday, and again on weekend you can have fresh dough, so that if something is not prepared also you can easily make fresh chapatis in morning and you can have the homemade food. Definitely if you will make this meal planning, this whole routine, so if you are late in the morning also for getting up, so you will not go empty stomach, your husband will not go empty stomach, your kids will not go without tiffin. You can provide some or other thing, like if you talk about fenugreek leaves, so to clean them and keeping on a kitchen towel, store in an airtight container and keep inside the refrigerator. What if you are not having anything, you can knead that only in the dough and you can make parathas of it, so that you all can have something fresh and homemade. So on this note, I hope so you have liked this video, and if you liked it, do like, comment and share, and let me know how did you find it. And in all my videos I say be positive and be happy. I know this is a tough job of doing it on weekend because it's Sunday, everyone wants rest, but do it with positive and happiness, it's for your family, so definitely you will make something great and it will be a great experience for you for your whole week, and you will definitely enjoy and you will be much relaxed for your whole week, especially if you're working. So do try this and let me know below in the comment section, did you find it useful or not? So on this note, I say bye-bye, take care, see you in my next video. Bye-bye.